familiar, March 2018, where we're going to be talking about the Emperor and the Fours. And we're going to be learning some tarot. So, oh cool, hi Gabrielle, she sees us. I wanted to start with something a little different today. I wanted to start with a statement on the acknowledgement of traditional land. As we gather at Hack Lab, we acknowledge the sacred land on which the Hack Lab operates. It has been a site of human activity for 15,000 years, and this land is the territory of the Huron, Wendat, and Petun First Nations, the Seneca, and most recently the Mississaugas of Credit River. The territory was the subject of the Dish with One Spoon Wampum Belt Covenant, an agreement between the Iroquois Confederacy and the Confederacy of the Ojibwe and allied nations to peaceably share and care for the resources around the Great Lakes. Today, the meeting place of Toronto is still the home to many Indigenous people from across the Turtle Island, and we are grateful to have the opportunity to work in the community on this territory. We are also mindful of the broken covenants we need to strive to make right with all our relations. So, and I remember this I got from Emmanuel College at the University of Toronto from November 6, 2014, and I remember something about the Haudenosaunee, and they are also a traditional native peoples of this territory. So, we're acknowledging the sacred land that we are having our meeting on, and yeah, cool. Let's get started. To my left is Joseph. He's our tech guy, and without him, this 360 degree and also 3D video would not be possible. I know, very cool. So somehow you can do a 3D with it. I think if you have,
If you get into like a Oculus,
they might,
or
they might
be something like that. Then you can over those things, and you have one. Absolutely, check it. I'm sure you have one.
Yep, and otherwise, if you're watching on Facebook, you can zoom in. It's pretty wild.
And you can scroll around, too.
Like you can scroll around and zoom in.
You can scroll and see just for
the live feed that's on the Facebook page itself should just show the individual frame, not all frames you get to see.
Mm-hmm.
Just a bonus for yourself.
A bonus, and yet so confusing. also, I'd like to introduce you to Eric, who's sitting across from me. Mew, I hope you don't mind. You're on camera.
I know. I'm aware.
Okay, cool. And Mew
is
hanging out, maybe joining us, probably not. I don't know.
We'll just call for the peanut gallery.
Cool. So, I guess we can do a quick recap. Most of these files are up on the website, on the Facebook page. So you can find the tarot elements, which I'm reading from, as well as our first handout, which was Zero the Fool, number one, the Magician. There's twos too. They're in here somewhere. The twos and the High Priestess, the threes and the Empress, and we're doing the fours today. So, I don't think I have my High Priestess handout handy, but that's okay. I'm pretty good with her. Oh, here she is. Awesome, found her. Okay, so just to recap, the elements. Wands are fire, and they represent the intellect. Cups are water, and they represent feelings. Swords are air. Wands are fire and they represent spirituality. Swords are air and they represent intellect. Oops, sorry about that. Pentacles are the earth element and they represent earthly, material world and as well as money and things like that, which goes into material. Zero is the enigma and represents the Fool. There's only one zero card in the deck. And he or she represents the start of a journey and going into your journey with hopeful expectations and almost a sense of naivete, not really knowing what the road ahead carries. The Magician signifies the spark of the creative energy inspiration. The aces are the same concept but applied to each of the elements. The High Priestess is the number two in the major arcana, and she represents bless you. She represents intuition and the innate knowledge that we all have, and wisdom. And the twos represent the duality and balance in life, and applied to each of the elements. The threes represent creativity and expansion, and that applies to all the elements. And the Empress represents fertility and creation on the physical plane. And yeah, that's us caught up. Boom, 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 boom. Cool.
It's like we're experts.
I know, I can like fake this pretty good. I'm getting pretty good at this thing. All right, what do I?
Well,
I was looking for some numbers in my deck.
Are we starting with the Emperor?
Yes, we are going to, or well, I guess we could start with the,
fours in general?
Yeah. The number four is always a good place to start, just simply because the four applies to all of the four elements. I'm just sifting through my decks because I want to find all my fours. Oh, well, I got a couple from the Egyptian deck. Cool. All right. So, four is a number where zero is the enigma and the cipher. One is the spark. Two is the balance and duality. Three is creativity, and four is stability. So think about it like the four legs of a table. It's very stable, and it's very strong. So you've got a number that's very strong, very stable, and dependable. Fours apply structure and solidity to the elements. Even the look of the actual numeral four indicates structure and stability. Considered by Pythagoras to be the root of all things, the first perfect number, and the source of nature and the living manifestation of God, in a way, it's the opposite of the three. It's not as dynamic, it's not as creative. It has to do with security, your home, not being your castle so much, like you don't need a gold toilet, but your home is your respite. It's your, kind of like if you were, one time I had you're on camera right now, by the way, BTW. This is Misha, he's our scientist. He is DNA printing right now. Where was I? Oh, yeah, so I once owned a snake as a pet, and when you do that, you need to have a place for them to hide, because they aren't very social, and they want to hide, they want to get away from the world. So that's kind of like a boar energy. It's wise, brainy, intellectual, hardworking, productive. It represents consolidation. So as you'll see with the four suits, I think in every situation it kind of signifies like a rest and a consolidating of your concepts and your thoughts, and you're consolidating your emotions with your thoughts and that type of thing. It's realistic, it's conservative, it's traditional, foundational, moral, honest. Everything that conservatives wish they were, or what they are in public, but then not what they are in private, because we all know they're hypocrites. What were you going to say?
Oh, I'm just wondering, in Chinese, the four is extremely unlucky, because the word soup sounds like death.
Mm.
And it sounds like it's relatively simple. Like, it's also the number of fate.
Mm-hmm.
You can't control.
Yeah, some things you just can't control in life.
But it's weird, in Chinese buildings it's four that's missing, not 13.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's
some of the Chinatown buildings are like that.
There are some buildings down on Navy Wharf, which is right by the Sky Dome, where there were Chinese developers, so there are no fours in the building. So there's no 4, there's no 14, mm-hmm. there's no 24.
North Brook's the same. It's definitely something that's carried through.
It's, traditional foundation. There's like, it represents a strong foundation. Morality, honesty. The four directions, the four elements, the four seasons, four suits in a deck of playing cards. There are a lot of things that are in life that are in fours, and that tends to be an expression of the systems within our world. Whereas we were talking about with the threes, you know, there's a lot of things that are trinities, but a lot of the times they have to do with more spiritual things This is more like it refers to systems. It brings rigidity. It's like organization. I wanted to write organization, but that makes it sound like it's an organization of people. But it's more like your personal organization skills. Like, can you file? How organized is your life? That type of organization. So as in being organized. Rigidity, it can also mean a stasis, a stagnation, or a plateau, because when we get stable, we kick back and relax. Some of the most creative people in the world are the most poorest, because their unstable financial situation forces them to be more creative, to get by. And when you have money, you can just kick back and not do anything.
I would imagine also to do with them chasing the next idea or the thought. They're not worried about building up material goods. They're seeking knowledge and kind of growing and exploring.
Oh, stability. Yep. Gabrielle's talking about stability. That's absolutely right. And there's actually a rap lyric. Of course, I'm going to think about a rap lyric. There's a rap lyric where it was P-Rock and CL Smooth, and he says, the only time I get writer's block is when my Lucci's on lock. So if his money is fine, he's not writing as much because he doesn't need to go out and make that money. Of course, I'm going to bring it back to P-Rock and CL Smooth. Okay, so it also represents fate, things you can't control. And because of that, I guess it ties into patience and perseverance, steadiness, discipline, being pragmatic, stability, and consistency. Excuse me. So it's not the spark of force. It's the steady applied force. Like I'm thinking of bike riding. It's not sprinting. Because sprinting, you burn out quickly. I had a friend who referred to his bike riding style as being like a diesel train engine, because he wasn't necessarily the fastest, but once he got cooking, he could just sustain for hours. And when we were bike messengers, like, that's the name of the game. It doesn't really matter how fast you are. It matters how consistent you are. And that's another concept with food. In the sense of stagnation and stasis, it can be boring. For people with the number 4 life path, or generally numerologically number 4, is just steadiness and evenness. So, it could be like also indicate a lack of imagination, empathy or emotion, stagnation, and the resistance to change or the unknown. Because you can just sort of sit back and relax. Is that pie?
Yes,
pie. Hi, babe. It also also means staying the course, being on solid ground, and it's not a number of immediate action. So it's not the type of, it doesn't indicate, it doesn't indicate, you know, going into action right away. So if you were doing a reading or whatever, if someone was wondering what they should do, and a four comes up, or many fours come up, that basically means just chill out. The, thank you.
Not hey, edible for 10 minutes.
Down.
But,
that's not going to melt through the table, is it?
I put a thingy under it.
A thingy. Okay, cool. Thingies are good. So yeah, if you were doing a reading and several fours popped up, it means like just sit back in the cut, chill out, do what you're doing, stay the course, and the whatever answer it is you're looking for will become clear.
Also, I feel like I should mention gather resources. Like,
Yeah. Absolutely.
It almost sounds like it's preparing for a marathon.
Yep. So, like, in my book,
long haul.
Every card has a hero's journey thing, and step four basically is variations on the threshold. The hero slowly gathers strength for the journey. They all say slightly different things, but...
And it can also mean being in the marathon, because you can't sprint in a marathon. You have to find a pace and find a cadence and stick with that cadence. You can't, you know what I mean? Like,
you're not going slow, you're not just slouching along.
Yeah.
It's consistent.
It's
even force.
Or whatever, if you need to go slow, because... The goal in the marathon is not necessarily to win. It's just to finish.
Yeah.
What were you going to say?
Oh, just, again, like, it's at the threshold. Like, the race is about to begin.
Mm-hmm,
you gather resources, or you have gathered the resources.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And you're, like, kind of trepidatious. That's the part about,
so
like,
just click
like, your whole now. You're having
live
start your first step.
Okay,
but,
watching
like,
on Facebook.
You are
about to join. Feel free to sit down.
Yeah, yeah, feel free to sit down. You know what it is?
Aaron
likes pie. He's following his food.
Yeah, you can't eat it for like 15 more minutes because, of course, it's scorchingly hot. But eventually,
do we have
really
a deck? Maybe do you have Aaron to take a look at?
Can I try?
Yeah, oh yeah.
So we're not really doing readings per se right now.
Yeah.
We're actually kind of more.
We're just learning.
We're studying words. So we're learning about what the fours are about.
Oh, and you can use that, actually.
Ooh. Oh, is that a shot at the...
Yeah.
Wade...
That's the Rider-Waite-Smith, which is the traditional tarot deck that was standardized in the 1914, just to bring all the concepts together.
I actually tried once in the Yonge Street one.
Yeah?
The one across the internet.
Oh, yeah?
You got a tarot reading?
Yeah.
Nice.
Do you know that place? How did you feel about it when you were done? Did you feel it reflected yourself, or...?
Not really. It's kind of normal.
It's
says
generic.
The same thing, yeah.
Yeah.
Instead, I can ask two questions.
Yeah.
So I think I asked my love life and career, and then she told me everything anyway.
Mm-hmm.
So,
interesting.
Yeah.
Yeah, sometimes, I think a lot of the times it depends on the reader.
Uh-huh.
And, you know, I'm just doing this so that maybe one day I can do readings without the book.
Okay. Yep. Okay. It's also way easier to do readings for yourself than to do readings for other people.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And just as kind of a refresh to your new here to the group. Number one, Eric has a really cool science tarot deck, which you might want to check out.
It's
which somehow multiplied now.
Yeah, I have somehow two of them now, which is a little bit bizarre, but okay.
And
especially because one of them is brand new.
Yeah. And then secondly, there's multiple ways to myself, I'm somewhat of the mind that it's somewhat introspection when you do your own tarot, for example.
Yeah.
So it helps you reflect on your inner self. And by doing the reading, whether you believe that there is a power or energy associated with it,
mm-hmm.
just contemplating your life and how the cards can apply to it makes you aware of yourself and brings yourself in. So you can look at it from that aspect, or even from a mystical spiritual aspect, depending on your preference and beliefs.
So, where's the conversation? Where are you at?
So, we're talking this is a study group, and we're talking about the fours. So we have the fourth major arcana, and then the fours of each of the suits.
Okay.
And we're basically just going to go through looking at our cards and comparing them to what they're supposed to be about.
And you can see by comparison, this is the Emperor. The Emperor in this deck, this was the...
That is the Terra Illuminati deck.
Terra Illuminati deck. So this is the Terra Illuminati deck. That is the Emperor. The Emperor's... the face cards are trump cards. Sorry, the trump cards, I think is the proper word for it. Is basically the very powerful forces. And then the Four of Pentacles and Cups and Swords and Wands, they're kind of like the same aspects of the cards, but various parts and individual sides of it. So like, for example, in this one here, Wands, Swords, and Cups, Tentacles, or Pentacles,
Tentacles,
fours,
nice.
Tentacles, there we go. Cthulhu always makes an appearance.
Cthulhu, yeah.
Is all aspects of the Emperor.
Mm-hmm. So we group the, while we're learning, there's 78 cards in the traditional deck. So we are, while we're learning, we're combining so that, right, you know, every session, every session, we're learning five cards at once. So we're learning numerologically so that the page in your hand is what all four elements mean and how they're represented in tarot. So when we do a number four, like we are today, the four is expressed through each of those elements as well as a major arcana card. So we get to learn five things all at once. Mm-hmm. And Angela said she would be right back, so we will probably be back. We'll still be on because, like any good discussion, we meander and go all types of different places, and we will be having a pie break.
Pie break.
Yep. And cool. So I just made a printout, which I probably should have earlier, just to tell people that when they walk in this room, they're going to be on camera.
Sweet.
No, so that we don't have to, like, you know, tell someone as they're walking and on camera. Cool. So we finished up the meaning of fours, so we can move on to the Emperor card. Let me grab that printout. Printed out the traditional. I'm working on getting a Rider Waite Smith deck for the group because it's always just a really good place to start because it's the standard tarot deck, so most meanings are derived from it. And there's a lot of different ways to interpret them, but this is a really good place to start because it's just the standard. So, all right, so we can start with the Wands. Which is this guy right here in the middle. And cool, this is the Patch Tarot deck. Wands. I'm not sure. Do you guys see that? I can't even tell what's going on my video at all.
they probably have to scroll to the right spot to see it.
So scroll, and that's my Patch Tarot one, and that is the Four of Wands in the Yukioe Japanese deck. This is my beautiful Santa Muerte deck. I love this one so much. And my Egyptian deck. So. I think that's the crook. Cool. So, we can just show the wands there. So for the wands, it means solid and lasting relationship bonds, because you can see there's a couple right there and they're partying. It looks like it might even be a wedding ceremony, but it does have to do with ceremony and tradition. I was reading on one of those sites, at the bottom of the cheat sheet there is a works cited, so I encourage you, if you want to learn some more, I encourage you to click on those links. I will get to your surprise in just a minute. We'll finish the ones, and I will get to your surprise, Gabrielle. I brought it just for you.
Surprise.
On a day that you're not here, but that's okay. That's how life goes. It's like four. Sometimes you just can't control certain things in life. So I think one of these sites, I can't remember which one it was, of course, but it's one of them in here. I think it was saying that the Four of Wands has to do with ceremony and culture, and you could tell, like, there's even people in the distance. It's like the village is celebrating, and when you have, for instance, a marriage in a small community, and the whole town comes out, you have the town's culture on display. You have a family starting their own kind of spin on the culture, and that's what the card has to do with, like, the coming together of two people to start a family and start that family's culture and start that family's traditions and things like that. It can mean in a reading, it can mean a coming romance. It can mean prosperity on the way, or present prosperity, and again consolidation, like the consolidating, you know, your affairs with another person. It can mean reunion, like a family reunion even, or like a village gathering, a warm and supportive home or work environment. So a lot of the times it can, you know, indicate that where you work or where you live is that place, or, you know, depending on where the card lands, it can also mean in the future it's on its way. It's a celebration or gathering in harmony and peace. So, yeah, I haven't looked into the Patch Tarot, but they have very specific meanings for their cards. So there's a reason that this one looks the way it is. I'm not entirely sure what's going on in that one, but